Welcome back to Island Tea with your faves, Kevon and Amali, and we are joined in studio with Vikiesh. Welcome.
Thank you so much for having me.
Speak directly like in the microphone. Almost kiss it, but don't kiss it.
Okay. Close enough.
Yeah.
So before we start, I just have to read a comment because someone is on the live drooling over your platinum hair.
That's usually the case. First post I put out, the first phone call I got wasn't about the summit, was about my
hair. Your hair.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's platinum for real, though.
Yeah.
Indeed.
Yeah, Tommy Witty had to put you on blast. A little bit about who you are and what it is you do.
Okay. That's always, you know, a funny question, because what I do feels like nothing because it's so natural.
Mm-hmm.
For those listening that may not know me, my name is Vikiesh Pickering. I'm known for doing a few things. I do makeup, I do hair, I make jewelry. But more importantly, I love. And I think that's the best way to describe what I do. Mm-hmm. I love it. It's just expressed in different forms based on what's needed at the time. Mm-hmm. And for the purpose of why I'm here, it's expressed in the form of a motivational summit.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine that.
She's like everybody.
Like you blushing.
I don't know what's happening.
Me neither. Mm.
Good vibes. That's what's happening.
I guess that's what's happening.
Good vibes.
That's what's happening.
So you said you're here to speak about a motivational summit.
Yes.
Tell us more about that.
Sure. It's the Emergence and Affirmation Summit, and it's honestly been a long time coming. From since I was very, very young. Like, weirdly young, I had this curiosity about love. And I guess it came because I couldn't understand what I heard love was and what I was seeing wasn't matching up.
Mm-hmm.
So I became very curious about the definition of love. I started to, you know, be very observant in life. And looking around and looking at myself, I realized I was becoming comfortable in what was normal, but mm-hmm. I didn't think that what was normal around me was the best that it could be.
Mm-hmm.
So I became determined to what I called back then, break the cycle. I wasn't sure how I would do it, but I knew I would have to do it because something in me wasn't settling for, oh, well, this is normal.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody breaks, that's normal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everybody entertaining toxic relationships, that's normal. No, something in me knew that there was more to life.
Mm.
But for me, the love aspect of it means that I can't just do it for me. So I can't just go and watch other people be in the same place, stay in the broken cycles. So for me, I had to find a way to bring, not just to grow, but to help others come along and understand that there is more to life and there is something special about you.
Right.
Brilliant.
And so this forum is an opportunity for you to do just that.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And I'm pretty sure in your effort to share your knowledge and your growth and just the things that you would have you know, like you said, you were curious about.
Yes.
I'm pretty sure in that process, you also do continue to grow as well, I'm sure.
Of course, and I'm glad you said that because sometimes you give advice and people assume that you've mastered it.
Right.
That's not the case. Mm-hmm. It's that I've come into the realization of the need for it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'll forever be in the process of growing because I don't think we should ever feel like we have arrived to this perfect place.
Right.
It's about showing up every day and being better than yesterday. Like, you don't settle yesterday. Yesterday's normal shouldn't be today's normal.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You show up differently every day.
Right.
Love that.
So who is this, who do you expect to come and benefit from this and what could they expect from this from being involved in this?
Okay, who I expect to show up?
Or who do you want to?
Anybody and everybody.
Amali too?
I would, of course.
He needed the most.
the most.
I would always say, right, if you're running a business, there's like the perfect plan for operating. I don't fit into it because I don't see myself as running a business. Mm-hmm. I see myself as being on a mission to motivate and to inspire others into their best self. So they would tell you, in business, you have to narrow down your niche if you want to be successful.
Mm-hmm.
I want to reach as many people as I can. And I feel like if you put yourself out there and if you do what you do the way that you're supposed to do it, you're going to attract the people that need it. So for me, there is no limit, no age limit, no gender preference. Whoever needs it, you come. You had a second part to the question.
I was saying, what could they expect from the engagement?
Always try to find the best way to sum up stuff. And the best way I could describe it is this summit is designed to be like a shock. Like you come and you get shocked because you've been settling for so long. And actually did a video using a pool as a comparison. I work in hospitality and we visited a property where, you know, we were expecting people, but it was neglected. Mm-hmm. So the pool was a mess when we got there. And I'm thinking like, there is no way this is going to be sorted out in time. But called the pool guy, he said, you know, don't worry, I'll shock it. And he put in enough, you know, chemicals in the measure that's necessary. He said in a couple hours, it'll be good to go. Trusted him. And sure enough, it was ready to go. And that's what this summit is designed to be like, to give you that shock, to help you understand that there is more to you, there is more for you. But for me, that isn't enough because, again, I'm not running a business. Mm-hmm. I'm invested in your progress. So there's a follow-up factor to the summit. You, after the summit, you get 30 affirmations. And the plan is to see you through the month after you leave.
Mm.
And then you get 4 weekly exercises, 1 every week, seeing you through the month. And then at the end of it, there's a follow-up. Mm-hmm. Now, if you have any idea the kind of commitment that is
right.
for the amount of people that would be there, you'd understand the level of my commitment to transformation.
Yeah, definitely, because what you're describing there is not some it's not necessarily a feeling like you go to like on this it's not this one-stop shop thing.
Yeah,
right?
You come and you get high and that's it.
Yeah, right.
Then tomorrow you forget.
And then with things like this, people also think that, you know, like you said, the one-stop shop, people also think that you come, you get fixed, and your life is suddenly a breeze after that.
Oh no! Oh no! And the thing about growth, right, is that I would never tell anybody it's easy to go after a goal, to go after your dream. It's not easy, but that's it. You have to decide that you're going to do it anyway.
Right.
It boils down to it. Much of life is simple. It boils down to deciding and doing.
Mm-hmm.
Even if you're scared, even if it's hard, doing it anyway.
Right. And is this like the first of this type that you're putting on, or have you done similar
I have
exercises?
Done nothing like this before. And when I say I have, like, the platform is new. Like, many people don't know me in this space. This space. But if you know me good enough and you've had a conversation with me, you'd know I've been doing it all my life. Yeah. It's just that I'm comfortable in the back of the room. I'm okay with not being it. I actually don't like the light. But purpose would pull you out of your comfort zone.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to be ready to be uncomfortable.
Indeed.
So, tell us a bit about the summit. I'm reading the flyer here, and it says a motivational and inspirational experience that promises to jumpstart your journey to greatness. So even after, you know, the 30 days after the summit, what people experience at the summit, you do feel that if they take it seriously, they will see, you know, long-lasting effects and results in their everyday life, yes?
If you're willing to commit to the process, you'll be successful. Again, it's not something easy. I expect that some people will fall off.
Mm-hmm.
But those who are determined, they'll be successful.
Mm-hmm.
So from what you're saying, it seems as though there has to be an acknowledgement that you get out what you put in.
Yes, right. Definitely. Right. Like, there's no magic equation, you know.
Right.
there's no, like, for dieting, there's no magic pill. You're still going to have to exercise. You still have to put in the work. It's the same way. You come, you show up. What you get, you have to take it and make it work for you.
It's funny that you mentioned that because, I mean, we've spoken to some other guests here and it's come up in conversation here about how it seems that people recognize the need to work on their bodies physically.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes the other aspects of who we are get ignored, whether it's spiritually, mentally, emotionally. And so I see this as almost catering to those needs as well.
Yes. And that's so true. And it shows up when an event like this pops up and then somebody would make a comment, oh, I can't afford it right now. But I'm looking at you with a weave that costs $600.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that you can't afford it in the most cases. It's not a priority to you. And this is no bashing somebody who wears weave. Mm-hmm. I will shave my head bald today and put on a weave tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
I'm that kind of... So it's not about weave, but it's about feeling like you have to have the weave or that hot body or that perfect made-up face. Is the feeling that you need it is what is disturbing, but not realizing that you need to work on the inside.
Right. The other aspect.
We are really and truly is more important because there's something about coming to that place where you accept you with all your faults. You see the areas that you need to work on and you're willing to work on them. You're willing to get uncomfortable for a better version of you. Then you're able to show up, weave on or weave, makeup on or makeup, no matter the body size, you're able to show up and to be comfortable showing up as is.
Right. And I find it so interesting sometimes, like you said, recognizing the areas that we need growth and we need things. I feel like, especially now.
Yes.
What I'm saying is I've seen this trend where it seems as though people worship or, let me say, romanticize their vices. Right?
Mm-hmm.
They romanticize the things about them that they know probably I need work in, but because I'm not willing to put in the work, then I have to find a way to justify the vice.
I call it self-sabotage.
Yeah.
It show up differently in different people, but one of the things you hear a lot, oh, that's just me.
Right.
But you're satisfied. You know, you're satisfied with that. Awareness is the first thing. And if you are aware, this might not be a good thing. You don't settle for, well, that's just me. You fix it.
Mm-hmm.
You fix it, even if it means getting uncomfortable. And in the fixing, one of the things I've come to realize is that when we do become aware, sometimes it's linked to something in the past that makes us very uncomfortable, so we're not willing to go there.
We feel vulnerable.
Yeah.
We feel vulnerable. And a lot of times when we feel vulnerable, then some of these coping mechanisms rear their ugly head. Right?
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah.
So, Sam, tell us more about the summit now. Where is it going to be held?
It's going to be held at the Kuna Caribbean Conference Center on the 31st of January at 3 p.m.
And where is this conference center?
It's at Fortlands. You can't miss it.
Oh, that's in the annual billing kind of
thing? With the flags outside.
Some kind of credit union something.
Cooperative credit union.
Yeah. Okay. So it's called the Kuna Conference Center.
Mm-hmm. And after, immediately following the event, there's a cocktail or what I prefer to call a farewell celebration, because I feel like on that day, many people will say farewell to
the OM?
Yes.
Adult.
Yes. And don't get me wrong. You know, it's so funny because even to sit here and to speak like this is not normal for me, because I'm very humble, and even when I do something that, you know, warrants attention, I'm not comfortable with it. But for me, I'm able to stand in this space and to be comfortable saying that, because I understand that it's bigger than me.
Mm-hmm.
Purpose is bigger than you. So when you step into your purpose, the assignment on that purpose is activated, and you have divine permission to move and to do what you're called to do. So it's not coming from me. That's how I feel, like I can't take credit for what's happening.
You see yourself as a vessel.
Yes.
Mm. The facilitator.
Yay.
So we have some questions on the live. People are not, they're wondering exactly what it is the session will entail. They're wondering if it's spirituality, coaching, motivational speaking. They want to get a bit of a grasp on what it is.
We have quite a few presenters, and it comes in different forms. You'd have some singing, some poems, some storytelling, and then my story.
Okay. Mm.
And you say it starts at 3 p.m. here, is what I'm saying.
Yes.
How long can we expect it to last? Whenever you finish, or is just going with the flow, or like book out the whole evening?
No, you shouldn't have to book out the whole evening. The presentation part is expected to go for about 2 hours, and then you have the cocktail following.
Okay, not bad at all. So from 3 till about 6 or 6:30.
Yeah.
That's reasonable.
Just call it 10.
Watch your
time flies when you're having fun.
Right.
It does.
So it's happening this Sunday.
This Sunday.
At the Kuna Conference Center.
Mm-hmm.
Time is 3 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Tickets,
you have two options. You can either register online on my website, that's vicreation-inspire.com, or you can call me for a ticket drop off.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm glad you said tickets, because I feel like whenever I show up, I should give something. And so I would love to give a ticket to somebody who can use it, but may not be able to afford it at this time.
So all of us in the studio?
So I don't know if persons listening or on the wall could make a suggestion. It could even be you suggest yourself. Mm-hmm. I've had somebody do that.
Mm-hmm.
And when I heard this story, you know, it warranted giving that ticket. So I'd be happy to get some names, some suggestions.
Okay, so there you
go. Well, Amali definitely.
I think we all nominate Amali.
We're going to nominate Amali for this experience, because I feel like he will benefit greatly,
Jade,
from this.
Jade, the show.
Vikiesh, I feel like you have that power,
Jade,
to change Amali into the man that he is destined to be.
Oh, Jade. I believe that.
Jade.
I received that.
The show is about service, and we're here for our patrons, the listeners, okay?
That does not mean we don't want you.
That's okay, so
I would prefer if it went to someone that's less fortunate than
so
I.
So you can afford it.
So yes, he'll buy a ticket.
Will go.
That's awesome.
Man, weave.
Good point, Carlo. But Amali, I do believe that you have been on a transition of your own.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm working on myself.
And that's beautiful.
And you know what? Vikiesh might be the person.
Witty is not.
I terrible about it.
So that's a lot of love. That's all I'm hearing, a lot of love for you.
So if you're interested in going, you know, visit vicreations-inspire.com or message you at call you or message you.
Either.
Either at 765-6798.
Yes.
And get your ticket.
I have a question. Are you offering a virtual aspect of it? Because we have a listener called Cleo.
Okay.
I think she would love this.
Yes. Actually, it's available for viewing online as well. And you can
live?
Also... Yes, you can also register on the website. Mm-hmm. You, when you go to upcoming events, you have the two options to buy a register for in person or for viewing online.
You see? Awesome.
You see? So I nominate Cleo. Why is it?
Y'all ain't gonna do my friend that, you know.
Do your friend what?
My friend.
So when I nominate me, is love. Needs it more and is less fortunate.
Okay.
And Ali, what that. Type of question, like, if even though you're copying out, like, what is a question that you would have for Vikiesh, like, about you personally, in terms of, you know, this journey that you're on? Like, how, what kind of help would you want as a person that is on a journey?
Help to deal with people who constantly nag and constantly annoy me, like Jade.
So right. How would you get help to deal with me?
You see, dealing with people, you have to remember that the only thing we could control is how we deal, right? And how we react to what happens to us. So you have to be intentional about the people you give access to you. So it's in your hands.
So put up a wall between me and Jade to protect my own mental health and peace.
You do what is necessary.
If she is violating it.
You just tell her.
Because this glass here ain't enough. Oh boy. But yes, that's true.
It's all about access
and it's all about making yourself the priority. A lot of people, including myself in the past, used to always put folks before us and give folks benefit of the doubt. And in the end, you always get all 9 times out of 10.
Just give me the crown. That's the place I had to
grow. You get walked on.
I had to grow from that place. And sometimes you question if you're being mean, right? Because I'm so accustomed to being the nice person.
Yeah, give up.
But when you begin to grow, right, you're going to have to redefine a lot of things in your life. Like, what is nice when I allow you to... use me for your purpose, that's what's nice.
And then when I'm in need, you say me, that's wild by.
Yeah, and I neglect my growth and my well-being.
Yeah.
That's being nice. No, at some point, you're going to have to be okay with them saying that you change. Boy, Vicky's changing, you know. All I got to
change
say
is, all right.
Thanks for noticing. Yeah. Thanks for noticing.
I remember a very, very wise man once told me, because there was a point in time where I was, or when I was in school and so, my grades were falling and so, in one particular semester. And the dean called me into his office and he said, Amali, what's going on here?
Yeah.
You're an intelligent guy, blah, blah, this isn't like you, what's happening? And I said, boy, I just really caught up with a lot of other things and thing. And he said, Amali, there's a word that you need to learn that's going to change your life, and you need to learn to say it. And that word is no.
No. I know.
He said, learn to get comfortable with saying no and watch your life improve.
That's true.
And not just learning to say no, learning to say no without having to explain yourself unapologetically.
I had to learn that. And again, it's one of the things I'm still in the process of trying to master it, because you have to, you know, sometimes you have your circle, your very small circle who... you'd be very flexible for.
Right.
But you also have people that you would like to help, and it sounds like a good reason, so yeah, I probably should do it. No.
Mm-hmm.
No, because you have to remember the mission that you're on and the road that you're on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sometimes we give too much of ourselves, and there's barely enough left for us to achieve what we need to achieve.
And every single morning, the three of us in here, the three males in here, wish we had told Jade now.
You know, I heard Lisa Nichols say one time, you can't serve from an empty cup. If you take the time to work on you, be the best version of you, then you're able to better help serve after, everybody else.
Yeah.
And not only that, I feel like a lot of us, when we say no, we feel guilty about it. We have to get past that guilt.
Yep. It's your right to say no.
Because we're feeling savers. We don't want to make people feel bad.
Mm-hmm.
But in turn, we make ourselves feel bad.
Yeah.
Or we stretch ourselves so thin that we can't do anything for us. Like, when we give to everybody, what's left for us?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Can you hear them, Ali?
I don't like you. Anyway.
I don't believe that.
So,
I love a woman like
we a bit... Well, So, we're basically a bit out of time. Mm-hmm. But let's just summarize it all again for everyone. So, you're having an Emergence and Affirmation Summit.
Mm-hmm.
It's a motivational and inspirational experience that promises to jumpstart your journey to greatness.
Amen.
It's happening on Sunday, January 31st. Time is 3 o'clock. Place is Kuna Conference Center, which is
Fortlands.
Mm-hmm. The newer building with lots of flags in the yard.
Yes.
You can call
765-6798.
Or visit viccreations-inspire.com for tickets. Dress code is
fierce and fabulous.
Ooh, Amali,
if you're showing up to unleash your greatness, like some people ask, what I mean? We talking about you stepping into your greatness. Show up in what makes you feel good.
So, Amali, you have your full leopard print.
That's why we're going, eh?
in a silk robe.
Hey.
I'm feeling that.
What color and what kind of shoes?
The velvet purple.
Greatness.
Greatness.
Royalty.
Royalty, purple.
We're not nominated, but they're still boxer. Oh.
Anything else would be...
Uncivilized.
Okay, now, bar. And of course, folks, you can also go on the website and register to experience the virtual aspect of the event. And that costs the same
you
amount of money
so
as well.
You say it's so much nicer.
Mm-hmm, I'm in school.
Mm. No, it doesn't. It's actually $20 to view online.
Okay. Well, what we'll do is tomorrow, we'll develop some sort of way to determine which one of our avid listeners will be the lucky person to attend the summit.
Okay. Well, I'll leave it with you and then they could collect it.
We'll get some names and stuff and we'll make it happen.
Okay, that's awesome.
We'll shake a bag.
That's awesome.
Kevon Hanley. Anyway, thank you very much for joining us. It's been, really, really insightful for Jade, at least I hope. And I do hope she takes advantage of this wonderful opportunity. Jade, you want me ready to take a few?
Sure, thanks.
No, Jade.
Just want to take.
So why did you offer?
Because I want to see if you're my real friend. Yeah. You were supposed to say, Marley, no, and no, you ain't got like that, so.
Well, you just say you could.
Yeah, you didn't know to say no, Jade.
Jade, you see.
Oh, my Lord. Oh,
but
my
we
Lord.
Also have 5 nominations for Amali, so.
Wow.
I'm flattered.
That says a lot in it.
And insulted. Vikiesh, thank you very much for joining us. It was lovely.
It was.
Thank you.
Thank you for having somebody.
Let's wrap it up before more come, because I will say them.
And we do wish the summit, all the success.
Thank you.
And all the positive energy that the world has to offer.
Thank you so much.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
We've come to the end of the show. Thank you all for listening. Tomorrow is hump day. Just left me alone. Anyway, folks, we're leaving. Drive safely. Don't drink too much and drive. Please use our roundabouts correctly. Stay in your lane. Don't overtake in the roundabout. Indicate when exiting the roundabout. don't park your vehicles in a way that will obstruct our sanitary workers. And them and the sorry we saying play with all your tall this year. So
I understand.
Right. Block the truck, man. Block the truck. Block the truck and left fire open on the road.
Just to add, please stop threatening the Wavengers with knives and machetes.
I'm just saying, like, don't do that.
Like what did? I don't understand.
Like, it's entitlement, you know. It's entitlement.
What are they doing with the walker then?
A matter, as far as they're concerned, this car belongs to them, so they could do what they want with it. Okay. And I can understand that kind of mentality, but at the same time, no offend people's lives because you disagree. The folks at Solid Waste are very reasonable folks. I mean, you heard today that they get people up to a year to move their car, they're still in move the car. And then when you come to move the car, they want to slice and dice you like you're a piece of salmon.
Imagine that.
It's outrageous. We need to do better. We need to do better. And lastly, well, second to lastly, because lastly is Kevon's very important comments. But second to lastly, Vincent Juicy Byron, please address the archaic laws in this country that are victimizing people that are innocent.
Like
14-year-old sex with other 14-year-old children and only the boy. It is barbaric and sexist.
Justice for Jekwan,
or whatever his name is. We don't know his real name, so we make
up a
name.
Jekwan,
we don't know his real name. Anyway, and lastly, and most importantly,
you can't be everybody's cup of tea because you is not a mug. Goodbye.